Again, hi everyone. My name is Andres. I'm part of the Android team, and I'm happy to be here with you to do my first presentation in this academy. So let's see how it goes. Well, I will try to present data sets and validation rules in about 15 minutes. Then I will do a live demo in order to show you what I explained you before, and for in the end we are going to try to do an exercise pretty similar to the live demo I will do. So, well, as every one of you know, a data set is a collection of data elements grouped together for a data collection. No, so how is this displayed in an Android application, in the Android app? Is integrated with the activity list. Okay, so it's together with the program, with the programs. The way you have to identify it is with the subtitle dataset. So for example, here you will see a program for the track entity person, also here, but for example, here you can see dataset. So this means that this is a dataset. The access principles are the same as the as any other program, so you can share public or private as any other program, working the same way. And then the theme, the icons and color also apply. So if you can customize it, but if not, you will inherit the default one. How a dataset looks like? Well, we have the sections you can prepare in a dataset, as always rendered as tabs. So you will see as many tabs as sections you have. Here we only see one tab because there is only one section for this example. Then with these arrows, you can adjust the data entry column name, where you can put it wider or tighter. And this the way you configure it is, will be kept for the rest of the dataset you will open. You always can modify it. In order to navigate for the dataset table, you can swipe left or right through the tables, and you will see it, everything. So for swiping the sections in with the tabs, you have to tap in the tabs explicitly, because the swipe works for the tables. In tablets, you can put the phone in landscape mode, so we'll see in a wide way, so maybe it's better for usage. Okay, if you go to the first option of the bottom bar, you will see the details of the dataset. Here, you can see the completion status. For example, this example is open, the dataset. You can see the period. You can see the organization unit, and indicates that the dataset is not editable. You will see the reason why it's not editable here. Okay, let's imagine that we have a dataset completed and we would like to reopen it. If we tap on the three dots on the bottom, on the top right of the screen, we see a contextual menu. We have the option here to reopen the dataset. Okay, said that, I try to explain you how dataset validation rules work together with dataset. So for this, we have an example, a pretty actual example related to the COVID-19 test and PCR test, no? So this validation rule, what is going to check is that the number of PCR tests are less or equal than the total amount of tests done, okay? So if you see, imagine that we don't meet the requirements for this validation rule, so we will see the error in the Android application. And as you can see, we have like a title explanation and a subtitle explanation. In order to give the more information to the user to be able to solve this issue, you have to know that in the description section is the when you configure the validation rule, you will have to put like the main title you want to explain, and then in the instruction you should add the information to be able to solve this issue. There are different ways to execute a validation rule. So let's see the workflow how it goes. In dataset management in the server, you will see some options when you are configuring your dataset. There is one called complete allow only if validation pass. This, as the name says, is to give the user the opportunity, the possibility to complete the dataset even if the validation has not being passed. So let's play with the different possibilities. Imagine that we don't have this option mark, so we don't force the user to meet the validation rule to complete, and we have an error. Okay, for example, here the error is that the number of PCR is bigger than the number of total tests. So if you do the data quality check, you will see the error, but you have the option to complete anyway, even if the validation is not passing. Now, let's see what happens if we check the complete allowed only validation passes in the server. When you try to save and the validation rules are executed, you will see the error as usual, but you don't have the possibility to complete the dataset. So you are forcing all the data entries to be compliant with your validation rules. And the third case is when everything goes fine, even if you have selected or not the previous option, when you meet the requirements, you will see a text saying everything looks good. Do you want to complete? Yes or no? Okay. Now we can see this in the device. Okay. Let's see. We go to the data sets, and we enter in a dataset that is not completed. You hear, as I explained you before, you can play with the width and the height of the data entry names. Also, you can navigate between all the columns and rows, swiping left, right, or up and down. Okay. Okay, so here let's imagine that I have an error and I want to check the data quality. Okay, here we can see the error, and as I told you before, we have the option complete anyway. Now let's modify the server in order to don't allow the user to complete anyway if the validation doesn't pass. Okay, so I modify this, I mark complete allow only validation pass, and I save. If I go to my device, and I sync my configuration, okay. If I try to run the validation, I see the same error information, but I don't have the possibility to complete to complete the dataset. Now, if we fix, if we solve the issue, we have the everything looks good. Do you also want to complete the dataset? And if we tap on yes, we complete it. Okay, so I think now it's your turn. I will try to explain you the, I mean, the objectives of this exercise is to is how to enter data in dataset for Android and know how the evaluation rules display. Okay, so the exercise is pretty similar to what I have just done. So you need to enter data for the dataset COVID-19 surveillance. Okay, that is this program you should see in your home screen. And then you need to force an error in the validation rules. Then you should fix the error, save and complete the dataset. Now, as you have seen before, you are not allowed to complete if the validation rule doesn't pass. So for you is the way you need to do it. You need to pass the validation in order to complete. The submission is going to be two screenshots. Okay, one screenshot is the dataset entry with the wrong values showing the message, the error message, and then you should fix the validation and do a screenshot with the everything looks good message triggered. So that's it. I think we have plenty of time to do the exercise. Please let me know any questions you have.